honey. You have to get out and weigh yourself. What's today?
Sleeping time.
No. What's today?
I should have a bit earlier.
What's today?
It's my first day of a cut. I can't wait.
Alright, first day, guys. I woke up 10 seconds ago. Took a piss straight away. Now, weighed myself. So, 85.1. On average, it was about 84.5, so. Oh well. 85.1, first day. Yeah, this is what I look like when I wake up in the morning, so. Can you even see my body in this light?
Yeah.
So, this is what I look like.
A few moments later. We'll be right back.
guys. Update time.
So I'm gonna put my phone down quickly. 1 sec, bear with me guys. I just finished my push workout. So my high rep day today. Well, moderate to high reps. That's 12 reps. Alright, so the 5th of March, today's Tuesday. First workout sugars. Only 12 grams of carbs is pretty good. If you want like a low calorie post-workout carbohydrate and it's warm, have one of these. As long as you track it, put in MyFitnessPal, if you use that app, if you're following the meal plan, then yeah, it's not on your list. But if you're doing flexible dieting, what I do, what I preach, what I practice, what I do myself, track it in. It's like 12 grams of carbs, right? What's pouring out there now? So hopefully you guys can see me properly. So today's Tuesday. I started my cut on a Friday. Starting weight was 85.1 Friday night. Sorry, Friday morning. What am I doing? Saturday, I was 85.1 again. No drop. Normally I drop a lot of weight at the start, a lot of water weight, a lot of glycogen. So when you decrease carbs, you lose glycogen out of the muscle, you lose glycogen out of the liver, you lose water under the skin, out of your muscles. So a lot of that weight at the start of the prep or any cut, any fat loss phase really, you are, yeah, losing a lot of water weight and fluid. That's why you might look a little bit flat, right? So yeah, Friday, 85.1. Saturday, 85.1. Sunday, I was 85.5, I believe. Monday, 85.6, but I weighed myself probably 3 hours earlier. That was about 7 a.m. Normally I weigh myself around 10 a.m. That's what time I actually wake up, because I work at night as well sometimes. You know, my sleeping patterns are not the great. I normally fall asleep around 2 a.m. in the morning because I work at Woolworths as well as I do PTs here and there, right? So, and then today, 83.8, weigh myself around 10 a.m., right? Tuesday, so day 5, yeah. So, so 8, 9, 10, 11, 1.3 kilograms down, all right? Now, my macronutrients, they were 220-ish protein, 360, 350 carb, 80 fat, all right? I decreased about 600 calories. Now, on those calories, I was gaining weight very slowly. I was roughly, if I had a good guess, now every day is different, depends on activity, but roughly 100 calorie surplus. So 600 calories decrease, I'm roughly in a 500 deficit, right? Looking to lose about half a kilo of body fat a week, but total weight, I'm probably losing a little bit more than that, especially at the start, a lot of water weight, and your metabolism is at its highest at the start, your fat loss phase, so you're gonna lose a little bit more body fat than expected, all right? So roughly a kilo a week for about 4 weeks, then it's gonna slow down to about half a kilo a week, all right? And then 400 grams and 300 grams and so on. Your body adapts along the way. Your metabolic rate slows down. The more you're in a deficit, the more you're losing fat, which sucks, but you can't help that. So the same protein intake, it's probably about 10 grams less just because I'm taking in less carbohydrates. Some carbohydrate foods has some protein in it, trace proteins. Now it's about 210 protein, so 210 grams of protein, 250 grams of carbs, so I decreased about 100 grams, 110 grams. And then my fats are 60, so I decreased 20 grams of fat. So yes, I'll take you on the full day of eating in a separate video. So what I normally eat, pretty much 95% of the time. Sometimes I have like just a banana post-workout. If I'm craving something really sugary, which I was today, I'll have like a Zupa Dupa, right? As long as you track your macronutrients, It's not going to break your fat loss, by the way, you know. But I don't want to make this video too quick. It's just the start of my prep. So I'm just telling you guys what's up, where I'm starting, what and how my strength is. My strength, by the way, it's actually going up a little bit. And that's probably because I'm training smarter. I'm not completely trying to failure every single set. The more you push yourself to failure on your sets, right, the more fatigue you're building, your workout, the next workout's gonna suffer a little bit. So be smart about it. Still train hard, but leave about a rep or two in the tank. And only on the last set you wanna go to failure. All right, and I also did a deload about 2 weeks ago, so I'm pretty much fully recovered. So sometime, every 8 weeks I do a deload. I don't wanna talk about deloads. If you don't know what it is, look it up. But yeah, I'm all recovered. So after my deload week, I slowly bring back up the intensity every week. Fatigue. 8 weeks into it, deload again. All right, so second week in after my deloads, I feel pretty fresh. Yeah, hunger levels at the start, day two, Saturday, I was fucking starving. All right, excuse my language, but I was starving. Tuesday today, I'm hungry, I'm not starving, so my body's getting used to it. When you first get into a deficit, a fat loss phase, you're very, very hungry, all right? Your body's in shock. It's pretty much sending out hunger signals to get your body to eat again, because your body doesn't want to lose body fat. It will much rather store fat to survive than lose fat and think it's gonna die, all right? So your body likes homeostasis, basically, what I'm trying to say, maintaining itself. So ignore the hunger, especially for the first week. A couple of weeks into it, you're gonna get used to it. Probably halfway through it, it's gonna be pretty easy. Not easy, but it's gonna be better. And then at the very end of your cut, especially doing a prep, you're gonna be fucking starving again. So just ignore it, just push through it. It's completely normal, just accept you're gonna be hungry when you're losing fat. There's no way around it, really. You can eat more filling foods like sweet potato instead of white potato, or like broccoli, a lot of broccoli, things like that, sugar-free jelly, Coke Zero. And yeah, so energy, same. I felt a little bit less energy at the start. As I said, your body's in shock, you're hungry, really hungry. Strength is the same, as I said, a little bit higher. And that's it. So I'll speak to you later. Or in the next video, depends on how long this video right now has went for so far. And that's pretty much it. So thanks for watching, guys. Please follow my journey and I'll see you next time. All right, so bit of a food shop. Start again. Keep on. That's not food, by the way. Wouldn't taste nice.
Confidence for your bum.
Wouldn't taste nice. Egg whites. We've got this at Coles. Basically, what you see here.
Excuse me. We don't shop at Coles very often.
Woolworths. We don't work at Coles. We work at Woolies. Egg whites from Woolies. That's pretty much it from Woolies, right?
Mm-hmm.
And everything else what you see here is we got from Aldi.
It's Aldi.
Spinach. All right. You turn to Popeye if you eat this. Get some big forearms. Pumpkin, from out of here too.
Mm-hmm.
Bananas, eggs, spring water tuna. It's a new one, it's a new brand, so I'm not quite sure what it is, spring water, but that's all I get when I'm cutting. Less carbs, less fat, high protein. Sour cream, it's for the girlfriend, it's not for me, I don't eat this shit.
Hey!
Coleslaw, for the girlfriend too, I don't eat that shit. Oats.
Pretty much
every morning I have oats. Chicken breast kebabs. Check out these macros if you can see it. 14.8 protein, 0.8 fat. Right, but you will have about 40 protein every meal. Chicken breast kebabs.
That's what you just showed, just a different flavor.
Just different flavor. Oh, is it? Yeah. Oh, chicken breast, all right.
That's mine.
That's what I'm talking about.
That's mine.
What is that? Okay, that's hers. Light cheese. Some green peas. I'm about to say beans. 5-star beef mince, so the leaner version. If you're on a budget, get the 3-star, but just drain it. All right, under the hot water, get all the fat out. This is my hand too much. Gotta make this quick video. Pork mince. So beef, pork, pork mince again. Oh, same thing, pork mince. Pork steaks, very, very good macros. I'll show you the macros quickly. 19.7 protein, 0.5 fat per 100 grams. But we do about 200 grams in this bitch. Same thing, yeah, pork. Chicken breast, chicken tits. That's pretty much everything what you got today, right?
Yep.
Now this is, blueberries. All right, put that in my oats, frozen blueberries. What are you pointing at? This one here? Chicken thigh steaks. Oh, steaks, okay. So thighs, a little high fat, but you can still eat that if you cut them. Just be aware of your fat intake for the day. All right, 22 protein, 5.9 fat. So I would normally stick to chicken breast because it is leaner, but doesn't mean I can't have that every now and then. I just drop my almonds. And then I normally eat more than this stuff, but this is what we've got today. I have sweet potatoes. I've really got that in the cupboard, so we didn't get any of that. Just trying to think what else. I'm just trying to show you what I eat through the day.
And rice is the other thing that's already pre-made in the fridge.
Oh, yeah, rice, pumpkin in the fridge.
Oh,
pumpkin
in tubs.
So basically what I eat is eggs, egg whites, oats, blueberries, some bananas, some apples every now and then. I don't know, I'm a bit lazy at that. Show them that. Chobani Fit. So YoPros. So basically high protein, lower fat, lower carb.
Yogurt.
Steaks, meats, veggies, sweet potatoes, rice, pumpkin, oats, pasta every now and then. With like mince pasta, mince and pasta.
So spaghetti bolognese. Spaghetti,
yep, that's it. But keep nutrition very simple, so it's easy to track, right? So I track everything, and every now and then, if I want a treat, if I'm craving something sugary, I might have a little bit of lollies or some zupa dupas post-workout, all right? That's pretty much it. As long as you track the macros, you're in a deficit every day, you'll lose fat.
We'll be right back. Yeah, look at that meal, guys. Wow. Let's see how much it weighs. All right. Hopefully, actually, minus a plate. Oh, shit. 1,534 grams. I think the plate is actually 500. Oh yeah, 700. What's that like? Damn, that's like 800 grams of food. Almost basically a kilo. So guys, what I got here, about 250 grams of pumpkin weighed raw, 80 grams of white rice weighed raw. I actually guessed the peas today. I normally weigh out everything including the peas and veggies. That's about 150 grams of peas, if I had a good guess. 250 grams of weighed raw pork mince. And yeah, that's a shitload of food. Volume, guys, volume. Pumpkin and veggies.
Alright guys, bit of an update. So, 14th of March, 5 p.m. at the moment. Tomorrow I'm actually going to the Arnold Classic. So, I'm packing up my shit for, packing up my stuff for tomorrow. I'm basically right now I'm packing up my supplements. I'll take you along. So I'll show you what I normally, basically what I take every single day. Alright, so first, multivitamin, calcium, vitamin D3. Alright, I take four of these because I got 2 grams. So yeah, I got 2,000 IUs of vitamin D3 in this multivitamin already. You want to have about 5,000 I use of vitamin D3 a day, depending on sunlight and all that stuff. But I'm basically having 6,000 I use a day of vitamin D3. So calcium, vitamin D3, multivitamin, fish oil. I have to take about 6 of these a day. I'm getting about 3 grams of EPA DHA total. Vitamin C, glucosamine. Alright. BCAAs, make sure you're taking 2:1:1 ratio. Alright. You want about 3 grams of leucine. So this is just under 3 grams of leucine. So I take a little bit over a scoop. It's actually the first time I take this, use this brand. Yummy Sports, pretty good. And a good protein, good quality protein powder. Alright, so protein, BCA, oh, another thing, creatine. I'm actually back on this again. I have not took creatine for about 10 months, so it's been about 3 months now since I've been using this. And I'll probably make a separate video why I got off creatine. Basically, long story short, I had pancreatitis, right, attack. It's my really bad, sharp gut pains. They said it was a creatine that wasn't good for you or whatever, but I'm back on it. No pains yet.
hopefully never again, because the worst pain you'll, it just, yeah, it was bad pain. But yeah, I got off the creatine. My pains didn't come back. I'm back on the creatine, a good 10 months off. I haven't got any pains yet, so hopefully never. That's pretty much what I'm taking. I'm gonna end this video right now. And I'll actually see you guys in the next video, and that will be only tomorrow. So that video log might be up next week, right? But it's basically, as I said, I'm going to the Arnold Classic tomorrow, which is Friday. I'm going to film that. And yeah, I just want to stop here, guys. Thank you very much for watching, for sticking to the whole video. I know it's a long video. It's about, if I had to guess, 25 minutes around there. It's probably going to be the longest video log out of all the logs I'm going to film. Next video, I will try to keep it under 20 minutes. Hopefully 15 minutes, but yeah, it's basically 2 weeks worth. As a tomorrow would be week two, so of cutting. So yeah, it's been 2 weeks already. So yeah, guys, down 2 kilos, just over 2 kilos, and just 2 weeks. So yeah, I'm pretty happy about that. And yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, share, and comment.